Hi guys, welcome to Brick and Bolt. At Brick and Bolt, we value transparency. So we'll share some insights today to shed light on our RM stage. The RM stage includes end-to-end operations, including soil testing, digital survey, structural design to contact registration, as they are the base of safe and secure construction. These processes and customer approvals can be time-consuming. However, these assure stability and durability for your buildings. So let's dive deep into one of these processes, which is soil testing. So let's get started. So what is soil testing? It's like a health check for the ground. We dig in, we analyze the composition and strength of the soil and check whether the soil is suitable for the proposed building or not. So now let's talk about why soil tests are important for construction. Soil test helps us to decide the type and the depth of the foundation for your building, choosing the right materials for construction, and most importantly, to ensure the safety of your construction site in identifying potential issues. It's like giving your project the green light for a strong start. Now the next question is, as a customer, why is soil testing important to you? Let me break it down to you. Firstly, it helps you ensure the structure's safety. Soil testing checks the soil bearing capacity of the soil, which is also called SBC. It is the strength gauge for the ground. That means it tells us how much weight the soil can handle. Accordingly, structural engineers can design a stable and secure foundation for your home. Ultimately, it ensures that your home is not just stylish, but also rock solid and safe. So secondly, it will also help you with the costing. As I said, the depth of the foundation totally depends on the soil bearing capacity, and it differs from plot to plot. If the foundation is deep, it will cost you more, and if it is shallow, it saves your money. So understanding these factors are very important to more accurately ascertain the cost. Now, as a company, why is soil testing important for Brick and Bolt? Firstly, to design the foundation type and depth. Based on the soil test report, as per the soil capacity and your home design requirements, like ground plus one or ground plus two or more, our in-house architect team decides on the suitable foundation type and depth for your home. Also, secondly, to make an overall structural design. As I said, structural engineers rely on the soil test report to ascertain the position of columns and beams, number of steel bars required, etc., to ensure that your home stands strong on the ground it's built on. It also helps us in identifying any potential issues. The soil test results can help our structural engineers identify potential construction issues like sinking before they actually occur. So lastly, we also use it to check the material compatibility. Choosing the right building materials is similar to choosing the right armor. Soil tests provide insight into soil composition that helps us to decide the right materials for your home construction. So how much time does a soil testing report take? It takes anywhere from 5 to 10 days to do the testing and generate the reports. So let's discuss the soil testing process. Just like every other test, soil testing also has a few steps in the process. The first one is field investigation. In the first step, the team does a visual inspection of the ground to identify the soil variations, vegetation, and drainage patterns. The next step is borehole drilling. It basically means digging into the soil. Here, the team rolls up their sleeves and starts digging up the hard strata of the soil and collecting the samples. Hard strata means the hard soil which can take up the load of the entire building without any settlement, of course. Normally, the team drills two boreholes in a diagonal position. The next step is soil sample collection. In this, the team collects soil samples from different depths. Think of it like taking layers of a soil cake. Grain size analysis, liquid limit, plastic limit, and plasticity index, moisture content, consolidation and settlement tests, shear strength tests, example, track shill or direct shear tests, soil bearing capacity, and more. Once all this is done, we get a report of the soil test. Test results mention all the details to determine soil properties such as bearing capacity, shear strength, and compressibility. It also evaluates the potential for settlement, liquefaction, and other geotechnical issues. In simple words, after analyzing the result, our architects and engineers determine if the soil is good for construction or not. Now let's talk about how a soil test affects your cost. The result of a soil test will have an impact on the cost. As I said, a soil test helps to determine the type and composition of the soil. If the soil test reveals that your soil is loose or that hard strata are located at a greater depth, then the depth of your foundation will need to be increased, resulting in higher cost. In conclusion, soil testing is the most critical process in construction that involves examining soil properties to determine its strength, composition, and suitability for building. In essence, it is the most important step in helping us make smart decisions and ensuring your project stands strong, And in Brick and Bolt, we value your safety.